In 2024, scams come in all sorts of ways. You can have someone like Iman Ghazi coming up to you, sending you his $3,000 business course, selling you the dream. You can have people charging you $4,000 to be in a safe environment in a jungle. They will give you a stick that they found in the woods, and they will tell you to release your anger by slapping the trees and the ground with a stick of wood. And people actually pay that amount of money. You can get scammed by a man who lives in India and goes by the name of Jonathan. And you can get scammed by your favorite creators as well, selling you a $28 four-pack of cookies. Now, today we are here to talk about, once again, from one of the most humble creators out there who's been doing this for the longest time, Pokimane. Now, if you're aware of what happened in November last year, 2023, she came up and she introduced her new healthy cookies to everyone. Her community was so excited about it until they got slapped with the price tag of how much each fucking cookie bag costs. And after the announcement, after she went live, her community were not having it. They were telling her to reduce the prices because it is just not right for them to buy a bag of cookie for $7 a bag, and you're not allowed to buy a piece of bag. You're only allowed to buy minimum of 4 bags. And obviously, as a humble creator she is, this is how she responded to our community.
Like, oh my god, $28 for cookies?
4 bags. That's $7 a bag. I know math is hard when you're an idiot, but... Like, if you're a broke boy, just say so.
She absolutely shat on the people who made her, who carried her on their backs for her to come to where she is now and have a name, have a reputation online. Now, for the simps in her chat, the middle-aged man who have been watching her for years and have been begging for to get a jar of her fart and her, you know, sweat, they will 100% buy it. But for the ones who just thought the price tag is just very stupid, they went in the comments in the live and they started giving her shit. And this is what she had to say.
How are the cookies going? Good. I don't know if you guys saw, but we're doing a promotion today. It is not a broke boy's Black Friday sale.
It is not a broke boy Black Friday deal. So basically, she said that if you cannot afford a $28 four-pack of cookies, you are a stingy person. You are a broke, cheap human being who does not deserve to have the money that you have right now. It is only $28 for you to spend to get the best cookies out in the world, because she personally, you know, created them. She definitely did not steal it from some other brand and, you know, add like 3x price on it and just put a different stamp on it. Because the people who tried it said that it is exactly the taste, everything, even the shape is all like the midnight in cookies. This is the brand and this is her brand, Mina. Now, it looks exactly the same, but I have never bought it because I am, you know, a cheap, stingy person who will not spend $28. But either way, I am not a food tester, YouTuber, TikToker who tests food and gives reviews on the internet. I'm probably gonna be so ass at it, but maybe I'll do it in the future once the channel blows up. Anyways, you know who did a review on it? Multiple huge content creators, streamers, and the one and only Keith Lee also reviewed the cookie, and this is what he had to say.
3, 2, 1. The fudge part of the cookie, I'll be honest, drier than a bitch's pussy. Shit is dry.
Nigga, you ain't funny.
I'm sorry. I just thought these two clips will go very good together and decided to go for it. I know she's a changed person now. She apologized for it. It's crazy how, like, back in the day, it was so easy for you to just drop the N-word and there's no backlash from it. I feel like this goes on with a lot of small creators because they think, you know, they're not that big to get canceled. But at least she learned from it. She grew from it. She apologized to everyone and said it was a long time ago. And she became a better person now. Instead of, you know, dropping the N-word, N-bomb, now she calls her community broke. Now, it's been 8 months since that backlash happened. She came out and she apologized to everyone like a day or 2 days later with a very... AI, looks like the manager was just fucking pointing a gun at her head and be like, do this or I will end us both. And you just know you're screwed after Baba Charlie makes a video about you and talks, and with the influence that he has, You gotta make an apology video or you're cooked. Now, the reason you clicked on this video is because she opened the subject after 8 months of never talking about it. And for the first time, she shared her actual opinions without her manager having a gun to her head. And it went horrible.
But, and you pronounce it Mina?
Yes, Mina.
What is Mina?
So cute that you bought those. Like, I would have brought them if you wanted.
Oh my God, we bought them the first time when they came out, when all the controversy was happening. And then we just bought them again because we genuinely like them. And we said that on the podcast too. We're actually like, these are like good cookies, know. You know, and I'm not just saying that. We said it before we even knew you were coming.
Thank
you. So you came across you were like, yes, popping with these cookies. Everybody was talking about them. And I'm like, what's happening with these cookies?
Honestly, like last thing I expected.
The blow up of it all.
Everything that happened. Last thing I expected.
Let me stop you right there, Mrs. Pokimane. The last thing you have expected. What do you expect happens when the community who's been loving you and supporting you for years try to, you know, tell you that I love you, but $28, I can't afford it. You know, it's too much. I feel like this is too much. Please, can you make it lower for us? So we want to support you, but we feel like this is too much. And how you respond to them is poor. What do you expect when the community is trying to talk to you, reason you with that the pricing is just a lot, and all you do is call them poor and shit on their face and be like, you're a cheap person? Do you expect them to be like, yes, you are right, $28, I will spend $50 because you are the best and we will do everything for you?
I am open and ready to answer whatever question you have. This is actually like the first time I'm talking about it, post cookies. Everything. Because like people had asked me to do interviews and all this stuff and I'm like, it's just not the vibe.
Because I was so like shocked at how many people like came for you, mm-hmm. like just even like mainstream guys and stuff like that. And I was just like, because why were they coming for you originally? Because of the pricing, is that what it was?
Yes. So it's a couple things. The pricing was one of them, and I want to be very so we sold them at $28 for 4 bags, and the reason we did that is because like we're a startup. Even at that price point, I want to be very clear, like we were not making money.
Yeah, the margin.
As a startup, like you don't expect mm-hmm. to make money for years. You're just hoping that you're building something cool enough that maybe it'll pay off in like 10 years.
That is the biggest cap I have ever heard in my life. When you start a business, any business, you do not hope and sit and, you know, don't expect to make any money for the next 10 years and be like, maybe we will make money. Second biggest cap why I think this whole thing is fucking bullshit and it's just like an act is because when a person first starts a business, let's say a chicken wing restaurant, right? An 8-piece chicken wing usually costs around $15-$16. That's how much it normally costs. These are like Buffalo Wings, there's a Wingstop, all these places, this is how much they charge. And once you want people to, you know, you want to market your place, you want to have regular customers coming up to you, you want to show them that you are very unique, what do you do? This is literally what restaurants 99% of the time do. They make their prices so low so people will be like, oh, I didn't know this place existed. Majority of people will not spend $15 on a place that they have never been before. Maybe a small portion that they want to try new things. But if they put their wings, for example, 30 cents a piece, that's going to come up to like what? $3, $3, $4 for 10 pieces. You're going to get a large amount of regular customers who are going to come to you and who are going to test it out. And maybe like 30, 20% of them are going to become regular customers. That is how a business works. You bring the prices low. You don't make them fucking high because you're not making any profit and you want to make profit. If you bring it high, that means you do not want to wait to make profit. You want to make profit as soon as possible.
And so when people were coming at me for that, I'm not going to lie. I think like it hurts so much because I'm like, I've built such a reputation. Like I've been in this career and industry for so long.
Another correction I want to add to this. Yes, you, a creator, works hard for it, but you did 50% of the work. The other 50% is the people who built you. It's the community who fucking like supports you, donates to you, who pushes you up to become the next top creator because they love you as a person. Maybe that's what she meant, but the way she said it is the way is like, oh, I made this 100% myself. No one did it for me. Maybe she had good intention, but that's just the way I heard it.
In this career and industry for so long, I had so many opportunities to do cash grabs
And I never, ever did. Like, that's a really, that's something that I hold very close to my heart. Like, I try to be very considerate of my audience.
If you're very considerate of your audience, drop the fucking price.
Very considerate of my audience. Never promote things that I'm, like, unsure of or don't know where the money's coming from or if it's good. And so to have people try to kind of, assassinate my character in that way, I do think it hurt quite a bit. But yeah, the price point was one of them. And that was just because we were starting. If we sold them at any other price point, like, the shipping would have just not made sense. Yeah. It would have been so bad.
She said that if she would have sold it at any other price, like anything lower than $28 or $7 back, she would have lost money. It would have been so bad because of the shipping and all these things. Now, yes, shipping can cost you a lot of money, especially if you're like shipping it abroad. In this case, just start up in the US. You don't need to fucking bring it all out in the Middle East, in Europe, all over the place. Start up small. Once you start making money from it, once the brand is, you know, people taste it and it's actually good, then you will start having shippings and you will ship it to like other places. But you can always as well, like if you want to ship it to places like Middle East, Europe, you can always add the extra charge. You can always drop the price of a cookie because I'm pretty fucking sure that they are making profit from that cookie for the people who bought $28 for 4 bags. $7 a bag, it is profit. Now, Nutella Biscuit sells it for 14 dirhams, which is around like $3.5, $4. Over here in UAE, and UAE and US prices are very, very similar when it comes to everything, right? Houses, cars, food, fast food. Now, Nutella is an established brand who's been in the game for God knows how fucking long. And you are charging even more than them? Yes, I'm sure Nutella doesn't even make profit. They have been doing this for like 50 years. One day, hopefully, they will make profit from it. So it's absolutely cap. They say $7 and not making any money from it. How much does it fucking cost to just make these things, right? Like, you can just always, if someone really wants it and loves it, I swear to God, if you would have made the cookies, for example, $3, $4 a bag, and that's Nutella, right? That Nutella, it's pretty fucking good. Your cookies, Keith Lee said, it tastes like dry fucking pussy. Let's say for the sake of the argument, even if your cookies were like $3, $4 a bag, you can always charge it that way. People are going to buy it. And if people in the out for delivery, whatever they want, they can always pay the delivery fees themselves. That's what most of brands do.
We can sell them per bag through Amazon, through other retailers, and obviously it's much cheaper that way. It's $7 or something.
But that's so complicated to be a seller on Amazon. It's actually a whole process.
It takes a lot of work, and you can't just do that right off the bat.
Wow. Okay. Yeah. So, because I was thinking, and I remember that, and I remember when you did the math, you're like, you said you're selling it for what, 28,
but there's 4 bags, so it's $7 per bag.
Yeah. And for those of you who don't know math, and I was literally me. Because I was oh, that makes sense. Because I thought it was $27 for one bag.
I was a little too sassy, but also when I'm streaming, it's just me and my audience. Yeah. I forget that other people can are watching. See. Yeah. I just feel me and my friends.
First of all, it was such a serve. And also, but also real, because I did not know. I'm not a math person at all. So I was just oh, well, when you break it down, it actually, whatever.
Yeah, I think it also, dude, cookies or any snacks, the price point depends a lot on the quality of the ingredients. Mm-hmm. And so for me, it was so important that they be kind of better for you and have healthier ingredients. And we can talk a little bit about why. But yeah, that was one of the reasons why. So I understand people were maybe comparing them to other things, but I'm the reason why it's more expensive is because we really wanted gluten-free, organic, really, really healthy.
Now, last thing I want to add to this is, which really bothered me even when it first came out, is the fact that once you're bringing out cookies and trying to make them fucking healthy, it defeats the whole purpose of a cookie. It takes all the taste away. That's why Keith Lee said it tastes like dry fucking pussy. If someone wants to be healthy, they're going to have healthy type of food. If someone is craving some junk, craving some nasty stuff, that's they go cookies, hamburger, they go they have fast food and they have fucking candy and all these things. It's extremely stupid. You could have easily had gummy bears, okay? Healthy gummy bears. Sure, a cookie needs to be full of fats, full of sugar, full of everything. I'm sure that's the reason this host, Trish, who bought it and, you know, once she tasted it, she never even finished it because it was all gluten-free and it took the whole taste away. No hate to Trish. I don't know her. I just know that she doesn't know how to do math because she said, ooh, it makes sense that $28, you know, if you divide it, it becomes like $7 a bag. That's much better. Thank you. She goes on later on in the video and she says like she has no problem apologizing. You know, if people give me backlash in my community, you know, think I did something wrong, then I'm going to apologize for it. I don't have a big ego. But still, like $28, I think it's a fair price and I'm not going to change it. I have no doubt she got called after this podcast by her manager and the manager started screaming at her and saying, again, my friend, I told you we went through a 3-hour course on how to deal with your community. And again, if she would have brought the prices down, honestly, it would be very good marketing for her to be, you know, known as a person who listens to the community and in general have it in a normal fucking price range. It's more than Nutella. But anyways, just wanted to talk about this new video that came out 2 days ago and just wanted to share my opinions on it. Let me know your opinions in the comments below as well. Let me know, would you ever buy it? Would you ever spend $28? If you do, big kharuf. Big. If you don't know what kharuf means, ask in the comments below. Anyways, take care of yourself. I'll see you at the next one.